Test it to see if I'll be that.
Hey, I don't
you
know.
I think I might be hurt.
Turns, but I just decided no, I'm going to keep it.
I have a question. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. I don't need the speaker.
No. No.
Yes?
No.
Oh, they want the speaker for the micro. Yeah, for the recording.
How about just this?
Just this.
Yeah. Oh, you don't need the speaker.
You don't need
it. Just this little device here.
Oh. Oh. Oh, that's even better. Then I don't have to.
There you go.
He's got a karaoke.
Beautiful.
Karaoke out there. Oh, careful.
Who's singing for karaoke later?
Oh, there's the singer back here.
Yeah?
Grandson.
Oh, my God. Sing it. Sing, Gary. You don't want me to sing.
We've gathered today to remember and give thanks for the life of Bernice Snook. Bernice was the cherished mother of Wayne and Joanne, his wife, David and Kathy, Sheila and Reinhardt in Europe, and grandmother of Corey, Sarah, Jano, Amy, Jessica, and Andrea. And much loved friend by those folks who have gathered here. While we are glad that Bernice is in the hands of Almighty God, where death and dying are no more, we feel the sadness of her parting. And our sympathy goes out to her loved ones in their need. Bernice has died. She is no longer with us. Death causes each of us to experience a gamut of emotions. And emotions are part of our body's autonomic nervous system. Those are things we cannot control. So if your emotions tell you that it's a time to laugh because you've heard something funny, laugh. But if they tell you it's a time to weep, cry. Because remember, today our focus is on remembering Bernice and how her life intersected with our lives. And as we remember Bernice, we remember Jesus, his death and his resurrection that culminated in the glory of Easter morning. Let us begin our worship service with a few words from Scripture. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Jesus said, "Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted." He also said, "I will be with you always to the end of time." Let us pray. God of all comfort, in this time of distress and grief, we have come to tell you of our sorrow and to rest ourselves within the circle of your love. Your hands made us and formed us, and you despise nothing you have made. Set free our souls from restlessness and raise our downcast spirits from confusion and doubt to the steadfast love of your unchanging peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I'd like to read a poem written by Linda Ellis entitled The Dash. I've read of a reverend who stood to speak at the funeral of some friends. He referred to the dates on the tombstone from the beginning to the end. He noted that first came the date of her birth and spoke of the following dates with tears. But he said what mattered most of all was the dash between those years. For that dash represents all the time that she spent alive on earth. And now only those who loved her know what that little line is worth. For it matters not how much we own, the cars, the house, the cash. What matters is how we live and love and how we spend our dash. So think about this long and hard, for are things you'd like to change. For you never know how much time is left. You could be at dash mid-range. If we could just slow down enough to consider what's true and real, and always try to understand the way other people feel, and be less quick to anger, and show appreciation more, and love the people in our lives like we've never loved before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering that this special dash might only last a little while. So when your eulogy is being read and your life's actions to rehash, would you be proud of the things they say about how you spent your dash? And may you always remember that it matters not how much we own, the cars, the house, the cash. What matters most is how we live and love and how we spend our dash. And as we remember Bernice and her dash, we all have our own memories of her that made her the unique individual person that she was. And now Wayne is going to come forward and share part of Bernice's dash that he remembers.
Thank you. Well, that was very wonderful. Thank you very much for all that. I guess you hear me better if I take this off, eh? Don't need to see me. Well, thank you, world, for showing up. And thank all of you for showing up. It's not a lot that I can add to the different things that have been written about Bernice. I'm sure when the COVID restrictions lift and we're all able to get together in the springtime or the summertime, there'll be more people that want to share a memory. But you can't share one because there's a lifetime of memories. But thank you all for showing up. And I'll look forward to doing this all again in a few more months. Thanks again.
Thanks, Wayne. The Christian church finds comfort and instruction in the words of Scripture. This, I think, speaks to us today as we go through this difficult time. Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where will my help come? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who remembers you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in, from this time on and forevermore. Something else from the Jewish Testament is from Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, verses 1 to 8. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to break down, and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to throw away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to speak and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to sow. Time to keep silence and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. Amen. Bernice Snook, September 13th, 1928, December 9th, 2021. Bernice began to worship at the church where I'm the pastor, Gordon, because a friend of hers in the same building that she was living invited her to come join her for a worship service. And after that initial visit, she continued to worship with us. Now, Bernice was kind of a private person. She didn't share a whole lot with others, unless you knew her for a long time. But I did get to know her a little bit. And I knew that she liked to square dance because occasionally on a Sunday morning, she would wear a square dancing outfit to church. And as she was walking down, sashaying down the aisle and turning to get into a pew, that skirt would swirl and you could see her little legs just getting ready for dancing later that afternoon. I knew that she had something to do with plumbing. And I wasn't sure exactly what it was, but when I was talking to Wayne about it, he said, anything to do with showers, faucets, but if it involved a bathtub, no, nothing about a bathtub. Now, the stories that I have shared are based upon what I have observed and what Bernice shared with me and what Wayne shared. But when we share our stories, our emotions get woven as part of the fabric of life, especially when we remember someone that we loved. We have gathered to mourn the loss of Bernice. But in gathering together, we are also remembering her life and celebrating it. As we weep over our loss, some of us may even be laughing about our memories that we shared with her. Sometimes even weeping and laughing at the same time. No matter the emotions which arise, they are symbols of our love for Bernice. A businesswoman, a wife, a mother, a grandmother, and a friend. I read from Ecclesiastes, and these words stand out to me. There is a time for everything. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. There is a time for these wonderful memories, and a time to give thanks. And Bernice was very thankful and grateful for her time with her family. But there is also a time when we must say goodbye. A time when we must let go of this life because there is, as the writer of Ecclesiastes says, a season for everything under heaven. A time to remember, a time to weep, and a time to heal. Jesus taught that those who mourn will be comforted. A tool that can help during our difficult time as we mourn is our memory. In the days to come, it will be helpful to recall all the fond memories of life on this earth with Bernice. We can open our memory banks and share the common and meaningful experiences which shaped our relationship, your relationship with Bernice. The treasure chest of memories is one of God's precious tools to help us grieve. God has also given us the gift of tears. Tears that help us to weep. The gift of tears, I believe, helps us to cleanse our spirits. Tears come down from deep within us to cleanse and purge and open the way for the fresh waters of life, living waters of faith. And faith is the tool that brings healing. God has promised to be with us. There is a time when death comes, and when those who are closest to us are taken, a time when darkness comes, our hearts hurt, and we wonder, if not worry, what will it be like tomorrow? What will we do? And how will we live and laugh and go on? Since Bernice's death, we have all been wrestling with this void in our lives. We have been experiencing deep sorrow as we work through our lives and our grief. Because everyone here loved Bernice. The loss is ours. No one will ever replace Bernice. But we should remember that God will sustain us. God will strengthen us when we turn to Jesus. We are more than just physical beings. We are the love we share and the memories that we create. yes, Bernice, beloved mother, grandmother, and friend is no longer with us. But the God that Bernice loved assures us that even in the midst of the pain and the darkness, we are valued to God, that we are loved by God. For God so loved the world, that's you and me, that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Jesus went to the cross. He was crucified, buried, and rose again to overcome sin and death, so that death didn't get to have the final say. Bernice is with her Lord now, and as we wrestle with the void in our lives, as we work through our grief, remember that God will sustain us. God will strengthen us when we turn and ask for God's help. May the peace of Christ be with you. Amen. Today, we entrust Bernice to the hands of God. We therefore commit her body to its final resting place. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who died, was buried, and rose again for us, and is alive and reigns forevermore. Invite anybody else who would like to come and put stand on the.
I think if Michael Green just wanted to say something also.
Oh.
And if anybody else would like to say something after Michael, you're welcome to.
Fine, no problem. And after you finish talking, there'll be a silence.
Sorry, I should have asked to have a moment to speak before. So my name is Mike Green. I'm the president of the Rotary Club of New Westminster. And when I joined Rotary more than 35 years ago, two of the people who were most welcoming to us as fairly new to New Westminster were John and Bernice. John was an amazing Rotarian and Bernice was always at his side. They worked together and were so involved in so many community projects and helping in the community of New Westminster. John was instrumental, or they were instrumental in building the senior housing tower in New Westminster, the Rotary Tower. And they were such warm people. I mean, they were so involved in so many things, but they were always welcoming and always made us feel like close to the family. Even to the extent when there was a convention in Europe, contacted Sheila and had us with our five little kids go and stay with Sheila and Einhard. And that to me is just an example of the warmth of their hearts. So I just wanted to say a couple of words to express the loss. You know, this is a changing of the guard, but a loss to the community of New Westminster. You know, that they were great people. The old standard, you know, people who really gave deeply and unmeasuringly to the community. So I just, on behalf of Rotary, and just wanted to say our condolences to the whole family and to say how much we remember and we'll miss them. Thank you.
If anyone else wants to put... That was supposed to be a time of silence as you were putting the sand on, but the crows didn't seem to want to cooperate. Now let your servants go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. Mine own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people. Let us pray. Oh God, you designed the world and all things in it. Give us faith that in all times and all places, we may without fear entrust those who are dear to us to your never-failing love, in this life and in the life to come. Almighty God, as Father of the whole family in heaven and on earth, stand with those who sorrow, so that as they lean on your strength, they may be upheld and believe the good news of life beyond life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen.
I'm not much at making speeches. I don't know where to start them, and I don't know where to end them. But I just wanted to say how proud Bernice would be of Wayne. The last 2 months of her life, you know, before, like in October, she walked over to my house on her own, got out by herself, and it was in December that she passed, so it was only 2 months. And during that time, Wayne looked after her phenomenally. She'd be so proud of you, Wayne. And I just wanted to thank you for putting everything together for us. You did a great job. Thanks very much. And thank you all for coming too.
Well, I guess if there's no one else who wants to make a speech, they'll probably put the casket down to the ground level. And then we can enjoy some more coffee and chocolates and things and fellowship.
On behalf of myself, Stephen, my colleague Richard, Michael Crean, Kearney Columbia Bow, we want to offer the Snooks family our condolences one more time. I also want to thank people who have been around the family through your show of compassion and support. for the people who were able to make time via live streaming to join the family in such an event. Thank you very much. The service is now concluded. There is a small little reception right behind me. There's hot coffee and chocolate, and the cemetery workers will come at a later time to completely close the grave. The service is now concluded. You may go in peace. Thank you.
Said something on behalf of the square dancers, that's but okay. I think it's going to be better in the summer
yep.
because it's
yep.
too many stories.
That's what I said. There's just you can't yeah. describe a whole life in a few minutes.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you, Wayne. It was great.
Good. I'm glad you came up.
Yeah.
It was very nice of you to be here.
Yeah.
We were hoping at least two of us would be representing the square dance part of her life.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. It was a big part of it.
She's. Believe thoroughly, she's right now enjoying a square dance with Doreen Sillery. That's right. Another story.
Okay.
Yeah.
She's dancing.
Please enjoy some more cocoa or coffee if you'd like some. There's a bit of Bailey's to splash in there.
Yeah, it's right there. Yeah, you can hold it on the cup.
not going to fall on your head, too?
Well, we'll see.